Fine. So now, first type of cost is nothing but explicit cost. Okay. So what is explicit cost? Okay. Try to understand. First of all, it is a cost. Okay. It is a cost which is incurred. The cost which is incurred to purchasing. Okay. To purchasing or hiring resources, okay, are called explicit cost. Called as which cost? Explicit cost. So what is the meaning of explicit cost? Try to understand. Explicit cost comes under your economic cost. So in economic cost, we have totally three. So first one we are going to see as an explicit cost. Okay. So what is explicit cost? Remember here, it is a cost which is related to purchasing, or it can be related to the hiring of resources. Now what it means? Okay. For every goods, example, let's say, if you are purchasing the cotton, okay, to manufacture textile, then cost which is incurred on cotton is called explicit cost. Okay, because cotton is a resources to manufacture the textile. Okay, now let us see next one. Suppose if you are manufacturing a tire, then for you rubber will be your explicit cost. So bike tires or any automobiles, vehicles tires, if you are manufacturing, so what will be my explicit cost? Rubber will be my explicit cost because it is mainly concerned with the resources. So if you are purchasing the rubber, or if you are suppose taking the rubber, then obviously it is related to the production activity. So right, so we can say rubber will be my explicit cost. Now this is related to materials. Okay, now apart from that, what can be my explicit cost? Okay, so what are the resources which is available for me to produce the goods? If I'm having my, if I'm purchasing a land to set up a textile industry, then that is also called as explicit cost. Okay, next thing is, suppose once again, if I'm purchasing a land, or if I'm taking a land on rent to set up a manufacturing of rubber or tire industry, then that is also called as explicit cost. So mainly explicit cost are expenditures. These are expenditure incurred on hiring of or purchasing of resources. Tell me, everyone understood this concept? What is explicit cost?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any other doubts? Any doubts? Shall I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now let us begin with the further. Okay. Next one is something called implicit cost. Okay, next one is what? Implicit cost. Now what is implicit cost? Try to understand. Okay, once again, this is a cost which is related to the factors of production. Okay, you know what is factors of production, everyone. Okay, now try to understand. You might get confused, or you might get similarity in all the concept, but there is some kind of differences are there in each and every concept. There is a slightly difference are there between each and every concept. Now what is implicit cost? Cost related to the factors of production, okay, which is owned by the, okay, owned by the who? Producer. Now who is a producer? He is a organizer. Okay, now will be incurred by the producer himself, okay, which is incurred by the what? producer himself, right? So what happens in this cost? Okay, let us see one example. If you have taken a land on your own, you have purchased the land, okay, you are not hired the land, okay, remember, you have been owned the land, okay, you have been what, owned the land. Let's say you got your own capital, okay, owned capital, nothing but you did not borrow any money from others. Whatever you had your own money with you, that is in the form of saving, that money you have been brought into the business. And they say you had already land in your business, and the same land you have been used for the production of goods. Okay, now you're not hiring, you're not paying any rent and all, but still you are doing some expenditure on your own assets or own capital. Okay, but still you are doing what, certain expenditures which is on the own assets, nothing but it can be on your own land or it can be on the capital, but still that is a cost. Okay, which is again related to what, factors of production, which is again related to factors of production, which is owned by the producer. Okay, the producer himself will do all this cost, he will incur all this cost. Suppose he has been owned a land, and on land, let's say he is doing some certain expenditures. It can be rent related or it can be other use of that land. He is doing certain expenditure, then that will become implicit cost. Okay. But what is the difference between explicit and implicit cost is here. In explicit cost, either it can be purchasing or hiring. On that, you are doing certain expenditure. Okay, so it need not to be your own, it can be hired or it can be taken on the lease or rent basis and all. Okay, you are borrowed, nothing is your owned. But here in implicit cost, what happens, whatever the cost is there, it is done by the producer on his own assets or own land, capital or own labors which he had already in the factory existing. On that, whatever the other expenditure he will be doing, those expenditures are called implicit cost. Those are called as what? Implicit cost. Got it? The difference between what is implicit and what is explicit? Explicit, nothing but on the hiring of resources. Okay. And here implicit, nothing but on the owned resources, on the owned factors of production. On that, we are incurring so many various costs, that is called implicit cost. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So now, one thing understand here. Explicit cost and implicit cost. Okay. Explicit cost, it is also called as accounting cost. Now, why it is called accounting cost? Okay, these are some important key notes which I am telling you people here. Explicit cost, it is also called as accounting cost. Why it is called as accounting cost? Because such costs are recorded, okay, in the books of accounts. Such costs are recorded in the what? Books of accounts, right? So that is why we always focuses on explicit cost. Whenever you try to understand, whenever you see any industry, okay, when you are finding any cost, and if it is that cost is recorded in the books of accounts, then that cost is explicit cost, okay, because it is nothing but which is recorded, okay, in the business. So explicit costs are always recorded in the books of account, nothing but they are also called as accounting costs. Now, second one is implicit cost. What is implicit cost? I have discussed already what is implicit cost. Such costs are not recorded in the books of account. Okay. In reality, such cost we never consider. implicit cost. Only we consider the cost which is incurred on the hiring of the resources, or it has been actually paid when it is purchased on the credit or any other form of assets. So implicit cost, such costs are never been recorded in the any books of accounts. That is the main thing which you need to understand here. Okay. So what is most important for any business is they need to check the explicit cost, how much it is been incurred. Implicit cost is nothing is reality here, but what is happening is that you need not to consider here because it is not shown in any books of accounts, right? So this is the basic difference, both implicit and explicit cost. Okay, next one we'll discuss. Okay, something called as normal profit. Okay, what is this profit? Try to understand here. So in economic cost, we have three things we need to understand. One is explicit, implicit, and normal profit. Okay, what is profit? Everyone know, right? So whatever the amount which is left over the revenue minus expenditure, whatever excess of revenue or expenditure is nothing but your profit, whichever you will get in the business. So this is profit is nothing but it is certain amount which is what required, which is required to keep an entrepreneur, which is the amount which is required to keep an organizer, let me write as organizer, okay, in the production process. Now I will tell you what is the meaning of this one, what it means, normal profit. First you will do certain raw material, right, and from this raw material you are going to convert into work in progress, okay, and then finally it will go into what, finished goods, right? Then afterwards what will happen, this finished goods will be sold in the market and it will be consumed by the who, consumers, right? Then whatever the consumers will be paid, you will get nothing but you need to sell this product in the market and that will be purchased by the consumer and you will get certain profit out of this, right? So now remember, from the raw material till it convert into profit, right, there is one activity is happening, right, one cycle is formed over here, right? So what are you doing? Ultimately you are purchasing the raw material and you are converting into the finished goods and then you are selling that goods into the market and then the market the consumer will purchase and then ultimately you get some profit. This profit is nothing but normal profit. Now what you will do as a businessman, will you spend this whole profit, everything for your personal, or you can use for a business also, right? So what you will do, you will use this profit to keep for the next production process, right? Yes or no? You cannot use this whole profit for your self consumptions or self to keep it as the own purpose. This profit has to be taken in the business and that will be kept as a what, reserves, right? And from these reserves, once again what I will do, I will buy once again raw material, right? Then what I will do from this raw material, once again I will convert into work in progress and then once again I will convert into what, finished goods, right? So what is happening, this is an operating cycle which is in the happening in the business. So whatever the profit I got, okay, here I got some profit, this is nothing but normal profit for me, right? So what is the definition of normal profit? What did I wrote here? Normal profit, nothing but it is in some amount, okay, which is required to keep an organizer, nothing but in the entrepreneur, he has to keep this profit for further production process. He cannot say that I will use this profit, I will not use this profit for one second. Every company, every business activity, every manufacturing company, they will follow certain same process. whatever the profit they will get, they will keep for the reserves, and then once again from the reserve they will use for raw material purchasing and then working progress, again finished goods. So that is nothing but normal profit. So how do you say normal profit? What do you understand with normal profit now is the profit which is used to keep, once again, which is used by the entrepreneur or organizer in the production process, such profit is nothing but normal profit, right? Got it, everyone? What is now normal profit?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Chilvaraj?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Vijay?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir. Good morning,
sir. Did you got the concept?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now, can anybody tell me, just raise your hand. Who will tell me the difference between explicit and implicit cost? Just raise your hand. Who will tell me what is explicit and implicit cost? Just try. Okay, one. Ramya, she has raised her hand. Okay. Okay, two people, Vijay. Okay, fine. Fine. Can you tell me? Okay, both of them have raised the hand. One will tell. Okay, Vijay, tell me what is explicit?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Explicit cost is the cost incurred for purchasing or hiring services or resources.
Okay, fine.
When it comes to a textile industry, cotton is required. Cotton textile industry, cotton is the main thing that is required. So that will be the explicit cost.
Okay, fine. Correct. Okay, next, Ramya.
Sir, implicit cost means a factor of production which is owned by a producer, sir. Or organizer. The example can, it is owned land or owned capital.
Correct. Yes. Okay, fine. So, who is going to tell me about normal profit? Okay, Ramya, you can keep your hand down. Who is going to explain me about normal profit? Just raise your hand. Likita?
Yes, sir. Sir, the amount required to keep an entrepreneur in the production process.
Fine. Can you give an example for that? So how do we use this amount and all, basically?
Sir, raw materials.
Okay.
Finished goods.
What is the steps which is already there on the screen, I guess. How do we do, basically?
Sir, profit, reserves, raw materials.
Okay. So first, what we'll do? We'll purchase the raw material, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And basically, every activity of a business, it starts with raw material, which is very important factors of production. Then raw material will be used for the conversion into work in progress, nothing but semi-finished goods. And then finally, it will convert it into finished goods and we'll going to sell in the market and then it will go consumed by the process. Then you will get some profit, right? So always remember that profit is nothing but normal profit, which is once again used in the business for production process. Simple. All the profit you cannot spend like this only. Again, you have to use that profit into the business, right? You have to keep that profit in some form of reserves and some in the form of production activities in the business, right? Are you understanding? Whatever the income you get, will you spend all the income or will you save some part of the income or salary? Whatever the salary or income you get, you have to keep saving certain amount from that. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So shall we go to the next concept? Okay, how many people understood these three concepts? Just raise the hand. Explicit, implicit, and normal profit. How many people understood? Okay, all of you understood? Fine. Good. Well, so let us move on to the next one. Keep your hands down. Next, very important and one of the crucial part of cost is nothing but something called as opportunity cost. Okay, this is very interesting and very important also. Opportunity cost is what? Okay, let me first discuss the meaning of opportunity cost and then I will go ahead with the examples. Okay, now try to understand what is opportunity cost. Anyone know here what is opportunity cost here? Have anybody heard about opportunity cost? Okay, fine. I don't know. I think Rashida might be because she has learned cost accounting. Rashida?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is opportunity cost?
Not sure, sir.
Okay. If you don't know, not a problem. We'll discuss anyway. Okay? Fine. So now let us move on to opportunity cost. Okay. What is basically opportunity cost? Let me explain you first the meaning of that. It is nothing but the cost which is incurred on the next best alternate cost. It is nothing but next best alternate cost which is foregone. Okay, don't worry about this definition and meaning and all. I'm going to give you an example. With that, you will easily will understand what is opportunity cost. Next one is, all we know that resources are very scarce in nature, because from these resources only we are going to use finished goods, right? So what you can say is, to get one commodity, okay, to get one single commodity, or if you want to produce one commodity, we have to forego, right? Forego means we have to waive, kind of forego the another commodity. Now this is just a meaning of that one, but I will give one example. Try to understand. Let's say I have a land, okay, which is almost 2 acres of land. Now I have option of, from in this land either I can grow wheat or I can use this land to grow what? Rice. So I have 2 acres of land where I have option to grow either wheat or rice. Suppose if the land is to grow, if the land is used to grow rice. Now tell me, I want some interactive kind of here. If I'm using this land, I told you in this land, either I can grow. Okay, let me write here. Can grow what? Either wheat or rice. At a time, I cannot grow both the things, right? Yes or no? If the land is used to grow rice, can I grow wheat then? Hello? Are you there, everyone? Okay, now my question is, if I'm using this land to grow rice, okay? If I'm using this land to grow rice, then can I grow wheat?
No, sir.
How many people say no? Just raise the hand. How many people say no? Suppose if I'm using that land for to grow rice, can I grow wheat then?
No, sir.
How many people say no? Just raise the hand. One. Okay. All of you are saying that you cannot grow wheat then. Now tell me, what did I lost? And what did I gain? Can you tell me, anyone? What did I lost and what did I gain in this land?
You lost the wheat and you gained the rice, sir. You lost the wheat and you gained the rice.
You lost the wheat and you gained the?
Rice.
Rice. Correct. Excellent. So I lost the wheat and I gained the rice. Whatever I lost, right? Yes or no? Whatever I lost means that is called forego. That is called as what? Foregone. Yes or no? I foregone the wheat and I used for what? Rice. Understood, everyone? So it means the opportunity cost for rice is what? Wheat crop is foregone. So what is the opportunity cost here? I used the rice for my land for the production, but I foregone the wheat. So the wheat is opportunity lost. Okay. And what is opportunity cost? The rice is my opportunity cost. Okay, so now let me write here. If the land is used to grow rice, okay, if the land is used to grow what? Rice, then wheat not available, right? You cannot grow wheat then. Either you can grow wheat or you can grow rice. So wheat is not available. Therefore, the opportunity cost for rice, okay, is the wheat crop, which is foregone. So it means what? To gain something, you have to lose something. Do you agree? If you want to gain something, you have to lose something. Either of this, that is called opportunity cost. So here opportunity cost is nothing but rice for me. So I will gain maximum from the rice and I will lost the wheat. That is opportunity lost. So the next best alternative cost, okay, that is why I written here, the next best alternate cost, which is foregone, that is called opportunity cost, which is what? Foregone. Now, what did I wrote here? To get one commodity, we have to forego another commodity. That is nothing but opportunity cost, right? So if you want to get one commodity, you have to lose one commodity. So whatever you lost, that is opportunity loss. But whatever you are gaining or producing the best another alternative, that is opportunity cost for you. Tell me, did you understood this opportunity cost? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, can anybody give one example of any other? Can anybody give some example apart from this? Where you have seen the concept of opportunity cost? Can anybody give an example? Can anybody? Who will try? Hello. Anyone want to say any example? Can somebody give me one example of opportunity cost? Vijay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me. One second, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat?
So we can production of notebooks and textbooks.
Okay.
If we choose as textbooks, the production process for the textbooks will be more, and when it comes to the notebooks, it's kind of less. If we spend time on a movie, we cannot spend time on studying. So that will be a loss.
So what is opportunity cost and opportunity lost?
Opportunity cost is the money spent on the movie, and the opportunity loss is studying.
Studying. Okay, very good. Fine.
Is it right, sir?
Yeah. Anyone? Chelvaraj?
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, don't know, sir.
It's very simple. It's not where you are gaining something, but you lost something.
Yes, sir. I understood, sir. But example.
You can give your daily life examples also.
Like, sir, it should be have some meaning. No, meaning, meaningless examples doesn't work. I think.
Okay, but did you understood the concept?
Yes, sir. I know. I understood the concept, sir. But I'm not getting any examples to you.
Okay, fine. I will come back to Kokila.
Yes, sir. Sir, like the money spent.
Yeah, give an example.
Sir, the money spent on going a vacation instead of spending it on buying a new car.
Your voice is not clear, Kokila. I think there is some network issue from your side, I guess.
Sir, the money spent on going on a vacation instead of spending it on buying a new car.
Okay, so what do you will prefer? You will prefer to buy a car or you will prefer to go on a vacation?
Vacation, sir.
Okay, but remember, still first sem exam is not over. After that, you can go for vacation.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll come back to Lekita then now.
Sir, a person deciding not to go to work and having loss of pay.
Sorry. There was some network issue. I think my voice was not audible. Lekita, can you repeat?
A person not going to work and having a loss of pay.
Having lots of pay, na? Loss of pay. Okay. So if a person is not going for work and there will be a loss of pay, okay, correct? So what is your opportunity cost and opportunity lost?
Sir, loss of pay and opportunity cost is not going to work.
Okay. Fine. Correct. Anyone like to give any example here further? Or someone has been come up with all now, I think 2-3 example you got. So have you gone any example or you have been come up? Okay, fine.
Spending time with friends instead of...
Yeah, tell me, Shreya.
Sir, spending time with friends instead of spending time with family, sir.
Okay, so what do you consider here? Opportunity cost and opportunity loss?
Opportunity loss is spending time with family. Opportunity cost is spending time with friends, sir.
Okay. So right now you are looking for, I think, Shreya, opportunity cost more than opportunity lost.
Yes, sir.
After sitting at home, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I hope everyone got to know what is now opportunity, right? So shall I move to the further?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us go on to the further types of cost. Next one is something called as private cost. Okay. Now try to understand what is private cost. Okay, I'll just write in a bullet form. Private cost, nothing but, again, this is a cost of production, right? It is a cost of production which is incurred by the private sector firm or enterprises. Okay. So first, let me write the meaning, then we'll discuss with the example. Okay. It is a cost of production which is incurred by the private sector firm or any enterprises. Okay. So next one, what we can say, the private sector enterprises, or we can say the private sector firm. What is the main thing their objective is, which is maximizing the profit, right? maximizing the profit. So to maximize the profit, they take only into account, they take only into account private cost. Okay, they take into only account which cost? Private cost. Now I will just give you one example. What is private cost? Actually, there are two costs will come here, and one is social cost. Okay, two things understand. First one is, this is I am talking about private cost. Okay, these two bullet points speaks about private cost. Now understand, private cost is simple. It is a cost of production. It is a cost which is incurred on the production activity mainly by the private sector firms. Okay, mainly by the what? Private sector firms, or it can be any enterprises, because their main objective is to maximize the profit. So what they will do is that they only takes whatever the cost which they have been incurred. That is nothing but private cost. Now, for example, I will give one example. There is a company called Asian Paint. Everyone know this company, right? Asian Paint is nothing but, it's a company which manufactures the paints. Okay. Now, let us take example of Asian Paint only. If Asian Paint company, okay, Asian Paint company, they manufactures hazardous chemicals, right? Hazardous chemical means, of course, to manufacture a paint, they require a lot of chemicals and all. Okay, hazardous chemicals, and from this chemical, they what they do? They manufactures paints, different types of paints, colors. They give different varieties of paints. They manufacture using some chemicals. Now, paint is a product, which is a final product, right? Which they manufacture by the Asian Paint company. So now, what happens when they're manufacturing this paint? There are a lot of waste will come, right? It's called industrial waste, right? And this waste will be, obviously, it will be in the form of liquid waste. Do you agree with me? When you're manufacturing a paint, a lot of chemicals will be released from the paint industry. And that waste is nothing but liquid waste, industrial waste. This waste will be directly, okay, it will be what? Directly released to the river, right? It will be directly released into the what? River, without proper treatment. Okay, without any proper what? Treatment. So now what is happening here? The company is manufacturing the paint. The company is using so many chemicals, and that chemical waste is they are releasing, they are putting directly into the river. So, and this company is not taking care of anything about this river. They are not doing any kind of proper treatment, right? You need, because ultimately you are damaging the environment, you are damaging the river, and which is used by so many people for the personal benefits, and which is used by the so many peoples, right? Which is used for different daily activities, water. And you are releasing all this waste into the river. So obviously it will be no use for the river, water cannot be used further, right? So from this paint, whatever you will get the profit, that is for your own. So you just focusing on the paint manufacturing, that is nothing but private cost. You are just only focusing on how to produce the product. What is your product? Your product is nothing but paint. You are not bothered about any environment. You are not bothered about any rivers. Just for your own selfishness, or for your own consumption, for your own profit, you are just focusing on the how to maximize the profit. That is called private cost. Now, what will become your social cost then? Social cost is nothing but, if suppose if the Asian Paint Company, okay, Asian Paint Company, they clean the river, okay, use the river water for recycling into same company, or protecting, if the company is protecting the river, protecting the what? River, then such cost will be considered as social cost. That will be my which cost? Social cost. In social cost, what we do, okay, in social cost, we incurred the cost, okay, we incur the cost on social welfare. We incur the cost on what? Social welfare activities. Social welfare what? Activities. Now, if I don't use the any kind of social welfare activity, then river will get again damaged and it will create a lot of problem to the society, right? Then that will be a, obviously it will be a harm to the people, right? For my own selfish or for my own consumption or for my own benefit, I am destroying the natural resources. I am destroying the resources, right? That should not happen. So in an organization, you should have both type of cost. One is private and one is social cost, right? So now I want to ask you one question here. Let me see who will answer. Can you tell me in this particular example, okay, from year to year, okay, we have discussed this example. What is your private cost and what is your social cost? Already I have been discussed. Just I want to know from you people, what is the private cost of an Asian Paint? What is the social cost from that example? Who will tell me the answer? Just raise the hand. What is the private cost? And what is the social cost from that example? Can you give me, can somebody can tell me the answer? Just raise your hand. Anyone? Don't worry about right or wrong. Just try, because you're going to write a professional exam. Don't worry about anything. Just try. Trying is more important than silence, I can say. At least you have tried. You're getting the concept or not. How will I get to know? Okay, two people, they have raised the hand. Let it be right or wrong. Don't worry about what other people think. Always keep attempting. So two people, they have raised the hand. You have to tell me from that black color bold highlighted, what is the private cost, what is social cost from that example? Okay, two people, they have raised the hand. Anyone further? Let me see how many people have got some confidence. Okay, three. Okay, Chelvaraj, you tell me.
Sir?
Sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, private cost is... cost incurred by the company for the hazardous chemical.
Okay.
Social cost is cost incurred by the company for the for cleaning the river and recycling some things. Then also.
Okay.
Protecting okay. River from.
Okay. Okay. So you are near to the answer. Correct. Fine. Rashida.
Sir, private cost is the cost that is used by the company to produce a product, and they do not care about the social environment which they are causing trouble to. But in social cost, they consider the trouble they're causing, and they recycle the water, and they also treat the waste before releasing it into the river.
Okay, correct, excellent, good. So now you understood, everyone? Okay, put your hands down, three of you. So how many people understood what is private cost and what is social cost now? Just raise the hand. Okay, fine. So 8. Okay, fine. So majority, everyone have been understood what is private and what is social cost. Okay, fine. Okay. So now coming to the next concept, I'm going to start. We'll take just 5 minutes of break. So now it is a 9:05. Okay, we'll meet at 9:10. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll meet up at 9:10. Okay. So be here only. Okay. So exact 9:10, I will start the class. Done?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello, are you back, everyone? How many people are back? Just raise the hand. Okay, Vijay is back. Fine. Shrestha is back. Chelvaraj, okay. Okila. Shreya. Sahana, fine. Ramya, Likita, breakfast doing a okay. Fine. Thank you. You can keep your hand down. Let us begin with further. Now, new concept. So I hope you understood all the types of cost. Okay, let us start with the new concept in this particular chapter itself. So we discussed so many types of cost, right, till now. Now we'll discuss what is cost function. Okay, so let us start. Cost function. So first try to understand what is the meaning of cost function. Okay, it is very important topic. Once again, cost function. Fine. So what is cost function? Try to understand, everyone. Cost function, nothing but it determines the relationship. Determines what? The relationship between the cost of production and physical quantity of the product, or we can say output. Do you know what is cost of production? What is cost of production? Cost of production, try to understand. Cost of production, nothing but all the cost which is incurred to manufacture the product. Right? Like in costing, we have certain things, like, for example, to manufacture a product, I incur something called as material cost. That is called direct material. Okay, we incur material, right? We incur labor. Right, and we incur some expenses which are called direct expenses, which are related to the production. And again, we incur some factory expenses. Again, what we incur? We incur something related to expenditure on office. And expenses, or we can say overheads also. When you put together, when you add all this cost, then it will become cost of production. Then it will become what? Cost of production. So what is cost of production? It is a cost. Okay. Once again, it is a cost which is incurred to manufacture a product, a unit of product. We can say total output, or we can say the single unit of product. So we start with direct material. Material is required to produce a product. Labor is required. Expenses, factory expenses, office. When you add together, we'll get cost of production. So What is cost function? It determines, it shows the what is the relationship between a cost of production and physical quantity of what? Output, right? Then we can say that is called cost or cost function, right? So when you're trying to find out the relationship between physical quantity of a product and cost of production, then we can say that is called cost function. You're doing some function or you're doing some event or activity. Physical quantity means what? Let us understand. Physical quantity is nothing but the actual product, the actual physical goods. Right? The actual physical goods is nothing but my physical quantity. Understand, everyone? So when I'm trying to define both, when I'm trying to find out the relationship between this cost of production and physical quantity, then I'm explaining, I'm finding the cost function. Like, very simple, so many examples. Let's take plastic water bottle, okay? Let us say Bisleri water bottle, okay? Now, Bisleri water bottle is my physical quantity of output. This is my output, right? Now, what is cost of production? What is my cost of production now? Cost of production here, nothing but, which is the material cost. What is material? We need plastic, right? We need some kind of plastic is the major component over here to manufacture a water bottle, right? So plastic and other expenses, let's say design charges, right? Let's say labor charges or labor cost. When you add all this material, design, labor charges, then we are calculating the cost of production. Then we are calculating what? Cost of production. So when, what is now cost of production and what is physical quantity? We have been defined. Tell me, did you understood what is cost function now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now what is cost of production here? The all the cost which is incurred to manufacture the production of a commodity, starting from material till the final office expenses, all those are called as cost of production. Okay. Rashida is there? Rashida, can you unmute?
Yes, sir.
Have you studied cost sheet?
Yes, sir.
So how do you get cost of sale?
Selling and distribution overhead, sir. Once we add that, we get the total cost.
Yeah, we get. So, okay. So don't worry about other people because you will study in future also. Don't worry. But remember one thing, cost of production, nothing but starting from the purchasing of material till office related, whatever the expenditure you will do to produce one single unit of commodity, that is called cost of production, right? Now, let us go on to the further. Next, this cost function, okay? Cost function is been divided or classified into two types. Now try to understand, what are those? First one is, okay, first let me draw this one. Cost function can be classified into two categories. Once again, okay. First one is cost function can be done. It can be short run. Okay. Let me write here. First one, it can be what? Short run. Okay, and copy. First one is, okay. Short run function. So this cost function can be short run function and one is total cost. Okay. Now, under this short run function, we have, in short run function, we incur basically two types of cost. One is fixed cost. Okay, just concentrate everyone. Okay, just see here. So now concentrate here. One is something called as fixed cost and one is variable cost. Okay. So in cost function, in short run, we incur two types of cost. One is fixed cost and one is what? Variable cost. What is fixed cost? How do you define fixed cost? First of all, fixed costs are nothing but the cost which is fixed in nature. Such costs are what? First, if you say fixed costs are fixed in nature. That is a one simplicity of this, or we can say the beauty of this particular cost, nothing but it is always fixed. Not exactly beauty, you can say, but what is this name itself suggests? This cost are what? Fixed in nature. And one more thing about fixed cost is, fixed cost does not depend on output. This is the beauty of this cost. It does not depend, okay, does not depend on the output. I'll give an example. You will be very clear what is fixed cost in life. Don't forget this concept, because in future we are going to come regularly in your intermediate. In BCom also it will come so many times. What is fixed cost? What is variable cost? One thing remember, fixed cost does not depend on output. Next, fixed costs don't change. They don't change with the change in the output. That is why it is called fixed. Now, example, I will give one. Example is nothing but rent. Now tell me, you have one space, you have purchased one particular room, okay, where it is a big hall, and you are using for a production of goods and services. You have installed so many machinery, all the labors are working, everything and all. Suddenly lockdown comes, okay, and there is no production activity. Now tell me, there is no production activity means you have taken that particular hall or room on a rent basis. Now tell me, is the rent is depend on production? I have one question to you. If I take a one room or one particular hall and I am using for that hall for production of goods and services, okay, Now laborers are working, production is happening, machinery. Suddenly lockdown comes. Everything stops. Every production activity gets stops. Now tell me, will that particular production of activity is depend, like if I taken on rent. So now tell me, if there is no production also still have to pay the rent or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Whether you produce the goods or not, it does not depend on the output. The rent is not, you have taken the goods, whether you produce the goods, whether you not produce the goods, still you have to pay the rent. That is called fixed cost. Rent is fixed. You cannot say that I don't have any business this year and all, I will not pay the rent. No, rent is never will be claimed, or it is not depend on the output and all. So rent is my fixed cost, right? Now, what else we can say? Rent is one type of. Next one is something called as interest. Interest on loan, you have to pay fixed. It is fixed. Every year you have to pay the interest, right? You cannot say that I don't have business, so I will not pay the interest. No, it will be charged as a penalty. So these are the some cost. Next, commissions, and sometime wages will become fixed, right? Then sometime salary also will become fixed. All these things will become as a fixed cost. So rent, interest, wages, salary are fixed cost. But once again, sometime what happens, this salary and wages are kind of semi-fixed cost, but they, most of the time salary will be fixed for a certain period, then later on it will change based on the performance, but still it is a fixed cost for me, right? So that is called fixed cost. So remember, fixed costs are fixed in nature. Fixed cost does not depend on output. They don't change at all if there is a change in the output. Tell me, everyone understood fixed cost?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is variable cost? Variable meaning, what is the meaning of variable? Try to understand. Variable means can change, which can change easily. Okay. Variable means which can be changed easily. Variable cost are depend on the output. See here, what I'm writing here, you have to concentrate here. Variable cost are depend on the what? Output. Next one, VC. VC means variable cost. Variable cost will change, okay? Change in output. What? Change with the change in output. If your output is increased, your variable cost also will increase. If your output is decreased, your variable cost also will decrease. Sir, give example. Raw material cost, right? Raw material is depend on output, right? You want to produce more goods, so you have to spend more money on raw material. Next, commission paid. Any type of commission when you pay, then that is variable cost. Means, if you are hired any kind of people who are selling agent, you have to pay them commission. If they are selling more goods, then obviously you have to give them more commission. If they're selling less goods, less commission. So the selling commission rate will be decided on the how much goods you are going to sell. So that is called variable cost. Tell me, did you understood everyone what is fixed cost and what is variable cost now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any doubts in these two particular cost?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Let us move on to next one, that is total cost. What is total cost? It is the overall cost incurred on the goods, services. Right? It is a overall cost. Total cost means obviously it is a overall cost. So we can say TC. TC is nothing but total cost is nothing but fixed cost plus variable cost. So when you say total cost, you are defining fixed cost plus what? Variable cost. When you add fixed cost and variable cost, that will become total cost. Okay, now understand one thing. If your output is increased, okay? If your output is increased, okay, now try to understand what is this relationship. If output is increased, then total cost also will increase. Do you agree with me, everyone? If output is increased, then cost will also increase. One thing remember, okay? Are you understanding, everyone? If output is increased, total cost will also increase. Now tell me, if output is decreased, what will happen to total cost?
It will decrease.
Right? So total cost is depend on what? Total cost is nothing but output. One is output, one is total cost. So your output is depend on what? Your total cost. Either of this also you can say, right? Yes or no? So output, basically, now we want to find out two relationship, two variables, right? Did you understood everyone? Yes or no? Got it, everyone? What is total cost now?
Hello? Yes, sir.
Any doubts still here?
No, sir.
Anyone, any doubts? Please ask me now. Do you understood fixed cost, variable cost? Okay, one line of definition. Who is going to tell me what is fixed? What is the difference? One difference between fixed cost and variable cost. Just raise your hand. Who is going to tell me what is the difference between fixed cost and variable cost now? Just raise your hand. Who will tell me that? One single difference, one distinguished point. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, Kokila will tell about fixed cost, Ramya will tell about variable cost, okay? Yes, Kokila.
Sir, fixed cost is not with your output.
Can you repeat once again? Sorry, voice was breaking.
Sir, fixed cost does not be with the quantity.
Okay.
but variable but cost variable is cost.
Correct. Next, Ramya, can you tell me?
Sir, fixed cost fixed in nature. Variable cost can change easily, sir. Fixed cost doesn't depend on output. Variable cost depends on output.
Correct. Excellent. Example, anyone like to give? Any other example? Fine. One example can you give me of fixed cost, Kokila?
Sir, rent.
Okay. Next, Ramya.
Rent, wages, and all is for fixed cost example, sir. For variable material.
Yeah, for variable.
Raw material.
Okay, fine. Okay, so now you got the concept of fixed cost and variable cost. So we can say total cost, which is nothing but TC, is equal to, we can also put in a formula like this also, TFC plus TVC. Okay, can anybody tell me what is TFC? What can be
total
TFC?
Total fixed cost, sir, and total variable cost.
Yeah, good, very good. TFC is nothing but total fixed cost and total variable cost. So what is the formula for total cost now? Total whatever the fixed cost you have incurred plus total variable cost, you get it, total cost. Okay. Let us put into one example. Okay, so remember the formula for total cost now. I'll just draw one table here. This is my output. This is my TFC. This is my TVC. And this is my TC. Output is 0. There is no output. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay. These are my total output. So now let us start with understanding with this. Total fixed cost, for example. Now tell me, one thing, did I told fixed cost is fixed in nature? Okay. They said fixed cost is 20. Now tell me, will fixed cost will change if the output is changed? Yes or no? If output is changed, fixed cost will change or it will remain same?
It will remain the same, sir.
It will remain the same. Yes. How many people agree that fixed cost will remain same? Raise your hand. How many people agree that fixed cost will remain same? It does not vary with the output. Output is changing from 0 to 1. Will the fixed cost also will change? So, 4 people, they say fixed cost will remain same. How many people say 4 people are telling that fixed cost will remain same? What about others? Okay, Likita?
Sir, it will remain same, sir.
Okay, you didn't raise the hand, so only I just call your name. Okay, Ramya?
It will remain.
it will remain same. Okay, fine. Vijay also not right. Okay, fine. So fixed cost will remain same only, right? It does not change. I told you here only. Remember. Yeah, remember this particular meaning. Fixed cost or fixed? Fixed cost does not depend on output. How much ever you produce the output, it does not matter. It always remain same. So fixed cost, I will put 20 everywhere. Okay? Now, variable cost. Okay? There is no output means there will be no variable cost also. Zero. Now, let us see. Let's check another variable cost is 8. Just I'm taking one number, 14. Last one question based on this table. Why I'm writing a different number? You be ready with your answer. Now, whatever the theory you are concept learned, you have to tell me by seeing this table, these answers. Okay. Can anybody tell me why variable cost is fluctuating? Who will tell me the answer? Just raise the hand. Why variable cost is change? Okay, three people, they have raised the hand. Lekita, Ramya, oh, she is put her draw hand down. Who will tell me the answer? Why variable cost is not fixed? Three people, they have raised the hand. Fine. Okay, so three people, they have raised the hand. Rashida.
Because variable cost varies and it depends on output. It also changes according to the output. Because the output is increasing, that is why even the variable cost is increasing in the table.
Yes, yes, correct. Excellent. Because variable cost depend on output. I told you in the beginning only, difference between fixed cost and variable cost. Am I correct, everyone? Chelvaraj, do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Chelva.
Yes, sir.
Do you agree?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now, Chelvaraj, can you tell me what is the formula for total cost?
Sir.
What is the formula for total cost?
Sir, total fixed plus. Fixed cost plus total variable cost.
So now total cost is equal to TFC plus. What will be the first one answer, Chelvaraj?
Twenty, sir.
Okay, next one.
28.
Okay, Shreya.
Sir, 34, sir.
Next one.
38.
Shreya.
42, sir.
Next one.
48, sir.
Hana.
52, sir.
Okay, excellent. Now, why total cost is increasing? Who will tell me? Why total cost is increasing? Okay, Rashida, she has raised the hand. Okay, Vijay also has raised the hand. Chelvaraj, okay. Three people, they have raised the hand. You can see the table and you can tell the answer. It's not so tough. Fine. Vijay, can you tell me?
Sir, because the output is varying, sir.
Because the output is varying. Okay, very good. Yes. Okay, Rashida, what is your answer?
The same thing, sir. If the output increases, even the total cost increases. They have a direct relationship.
They have direct. Excellent. Chelvaraj?
Sir?
What is your answer?
What, sir?
What is your answer?
The question.
Why total cost is increasing?
Sir, increasing cause of increasing variable cost and outputs. Okay. Output and variable cost.
Fine, fine. Correct. That can be also. Now you see, total cost have always relationship with the output also. So here output is increasing, even the total cost is also increasing, right? If you increase your output, your total cost will increase. If you decrease your output, your total cost will decrease. This is what I told explained here. Tell me, everyone is clear with this concept?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now if you know this concept, very simple. So one thing remember here onwards, if output is increased, total cost will also increase. Yes or no?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Let us move on to one. We can form in a one diagrammatic this one. Okay. How we'll form? So let's check. This is a one particular diagram for that one. So this is my x-axis. And this is my y. So in x will always will come output, okay? Here onwards you have to remember x-axis will determine the output and y will determine the cost. Output and cost. Now which cost is fixed? Can anybody tell me? Which cost is fixed? Y will determine the cost. Output x will, this is my x-axis. Tell me which cost is fixed. Let's check, this is my 10. Tell me, just now I told which cost is fixed here among the table. This is, let's say 20, let's say this is 30, 40, and this keeps increasing 50, 60. Okay, I'm just taking random. Just see this table, which cost is fixed here?
Fixed cost.
Fixed cost is fixed, right? Why are you taking so time to take, tell me the answer? Fixed cost is fixed, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, which cost is varying?
Variable cost,
right? So fixed cost is how much? 20, right? Answer, everyone keenly observe. So this is 20, right? So this fixed cost will fix, right? It won't change. Now, variable cost will change. So let us see. So this is my lesson. this is my which cost? Fixed cost. And this is my VC, variable cost. And one more cost. Can you tell me which cost is this one?
Total cost.
Variable cost.
This is total cost. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Why I written on the top? Because output increases, total cost also increases, right? That is what we have learned in today's class. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, fantastic. Okay, let us move on. What are the other cost? What are the other cost curves which are available in the short period or short run period, we can say? Okay, let us quickly discuss one by one. First one is AFC. What is AFC? That is called average fixed cost. What is which cost? Average fixed cost. What is average fixed cost? Listen here. Average fixed cost means it is a total of the fixed cost per unit. Okay, total of the what? Fixed cost per unit of the total output. Now, for example, how do you get average fixed cost is nothing but basically in average fixed cost, what we have to do, we have to check what is my TFC, that is total fixed cost divided by Q. So what is your TFC? What is TFC stands for?
Total fixed cost.
Total fixed cost.
Total fixed cost. Can you tell me what Q stands then?
Output.
Output. Very good. Output. So when you divide total fixed cost divided by output, nothing but you are calculating the average of each, average of fixed cost. When you divide total fixed cost with total output, then you will get something called as average fixed cost. Okay, now it will come in diagrammatic way. Let us see. When I'm defining this particular average fixed cost, okay, so always remember, average fixed cost, okay, is nothing but the total fixed cost, whatever we have been incurred in the business, of that divided by total output, you will get the average fixed cost. And let's say this is my X axis. And this is my what? Y axis. So in X, what we have to define always? X will represent what? Output. Very good. X will represent my output. Okay. And Y will represent what?
Cost.
Yes. Remember, okay, average fixed cost is always, okay, it will move. Okay. It will slope downwards. I will tell you why it is sloped downwards once again. Let me draw the chart. It slopes downward from left to right. It means what? When you increase your output, your average fixed cost will also decrease. When output increases, average fixed cost will also. So they say this is my output, this is my total fixed cost, right? So as the output keep increasing, okay, and the as the total cost or fixed cost will also will remain same, right? So what happens here when you take the average of total fixed cost and output? So your average fixed cost will come down. As the output increases, the average fixed cost will also comes down, and it moves from left to right. It moves from where? Left to right. This particular, there is a curve is created. That curve is nothing but it is called rectangular hyperbola. So now, what is this rectangular hyperbola? It is a curve which represents the average fixed cost curve, which moves from left to right. Why it is moved from left to right? Means it slopes downwards, left to right, because it slopes downward. Okay, that is why it moves from left to right. Now, fine. So that is why it is also that movement of curve. There is a curve is created. Okay, basically like there is a downward curve is created like this. That curve is called rectangular hyperbola curve of average fixed cost. Got it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Next one. Second one is AVC. Can anybody tell me what can be AVC?
Average variable cost.
Average variable cost. Very good. Average variable cost. Now, what is average variable cost? Listen here. Average variable cost, how do you get?
Total variable cost divided by output.
Excellent. Very good. Total variable cost divided by what? Output. Nothing but Q. So same thing. Here what we are doing, we are calculating the cost per unit of variable cost. Okay. We are calculating what is the average of total variable cost per unit or against the total output. So it means what? So much of variable cost we have been incurring, and we want to know what is my average, what is my on an average variable cost which I incurred. So that will give me answer of per unit when you divide with output. Okay, so how average variable cost will look when it comes to diagrammatic form? So average variable cost.
Hello.
Okay, one second. I'll just.
Hello.
Just see here. So let's check, this is my diagram. So average variable cost will be always U-shaped curve. It is always what? U-shaped curve. So how it will come like this? Okay, so now fine. So your average variable cost will U-shape curve means why it is called U-shape curve? Why it is a U-shape curve? Because it is vary, it can change, right? It can change. So sometime it can decrease, sometime it can be increased over here. So this shape is nothing but called as U-shaped curve. So average variable cost, this can be your MCQ question, will be which type of shape curve? It will be U-shaped curve. Got it, everyone? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so another two cost are there. Fine, not a problem. This I will continue in the next class. I think it will be too much for you people in the today's session.